Thanks for tuning in. You're watching Badminton Unlimited. Coming up, Latin America's first Badminton Olympic semi-finalist Kevin Cordon reflects on his Tokyo fairy tale run.
And I'm happy, not because I lost the medal. I'm happy that I had two chances to get a medal, so I'm still thinking like that.
Peru's para-badminton star, Carmen Giuliana Poveda Flores, reveals her source of motivation.
I'm sorry, it was too good, and I am so good to be his daughter.
And it's back to school for HS Pranoy, who tries to pick up a new language.
Hiu khao mai.
Ranked 156th in the world, numerous late withdrawals promoted Weng Hong Yang to the main draw of the Super 500 Korea Open 2022. A virtual unknown who'd been honing his trade in international challenge and Super 100 events, 22-year-old Weng grasped the opportunity to play his first international tournament in more than 2 years in Suncheon.
然后我是四号晚上才知道自己替补进去的嘛，所以其实也挺幸运的嘛。自己其实赛前没有多去想结果吧，所以自己因为也很久没有出赛场打公开赛了嘛，也有800多天吧，所以说自己出发的时候赛前的准备自己就是想哪一场去拼去准备好哪一场嘛，没有去说直接说去获得这个冠军，就是感觉自己就是。 期待值比较高吧，其实期待自己的表现，因为自己在前段时间在国内训练也训练的不错嘛，所以也想检验一下自己的水平是在什么地方吧。Playing
in his highest tier of tournament, Weng rolled past three better ranked opponents to set up a semi-final showdown with Victor Svensson, who was 81 places above the Chinese.
其实赛前我们没有交手过吧，可能也是 互相不太了解吧，所以说我赛前自己也是先把自己的特点啊和自己的心态啊都摆比较好吧，我觉得。我觉得自己就是整个场上的精神面貌吧，还有就是整体的速度，还有自己因为也是偏进攻型的打法嘛，所以说自己。 一上场要先把自己的这些东西先发挥出来了，但对手也打得不错，第一局我们俩都打到了加分，到最后只是关键分我可能处理的会比他好一点吧，我觉得。
That's a lovely winner from Weng. Oh, great from Svensson. And he can finish this off, and he does. And Weng is into his first ever BWF Super 500 final.
And won by Weng Hong Yang,
Indonesia.
The final hurdle for Weng was none other than the world number 8, Jonathan Christie, who was making a second successive final.
那场就也是第一次跟就是世界前十的队员交手嘛，所以说对手实力还是很强的，所以说自己的心态就也是摆得去冲击对手的心态嘛，所以说自己整个的可能心态会比对手会好一点。但是呢，自己在场上第一局还是表现呢还是没有那么的好吧，可能因为对手实力比较强，所以说给自己造成的压力也是蛮大的。
Nicely done. Oh, beautiful in that lovely disguise. easily put away. That's better from him, Weng Hong Yang. Good power, and Christie powers through the first game as well, very comfortably, 21-12.
后面自己第二局又慢慢的调整过来，就放下包袱去拼每一分嘛。其实到了末端的时候，自己也没有去想的特别多了，就是放开包袱去拼嘛。所以说呢，反而会感觉自己整个人会更轻松一点，会放得更开一点。
Oh, there it is, that booming smash. What a shot that was. Great reactions from Weng Hong Yang. Have a look at this. Nicely done. The left. Three good points here for Christie. That's a big roar, that one, from the crowd.
Fantastic save.
What a save.
And he really needed that one to stay in the game now. Instead of four match points against him, he's just 2 points adrift.
Oh, he's drawn level.
Can one convert this?
Has drawn level. Wow.
主要还是跟对手去相持吧，然后而且还是要把自己的特点东西打出来，因为我们俩没有交手嘛，所以说可能我不适应他的球路，他也不适应我的球路，所以说到后面可能都一些球可能我们俩都互相不适应嘛，所以导致会可能会消耗的都比较大。
Jonathan Christie still has enough left in the tank. Oh, that surely suggests that he has. Good shot.
He'll be brimming with confidence at the moment, Weng. Good defense there. Oh, he's done well to stay in this.
Oy, oh, that's amazing.
What a rally. Weng Hong Yang looked dead and buried about 30 seconds ago and stuck in it. And he's come out with the point.
Oi, for the save.
Good save there. Can he go on now?
It's gone long.
Oh, it's long. It is long.
Yeah, that's a beautiful play.
Oh. He's done it. Weng Hong Yang, promoted from the reserves, has gone all the way here in the biggest match of his career so far. He's beaten a man almost 150 places above him in the rankings.
当时赢下来自己其实也有点不可思议的，然后或者是有点另外一种心情，就是感觉自己这就赢下来，感觉就是很不可思议嘛，所以说当时可能也没有说特别的去兴奋，也没有特别的去庆祝嘛，而且我觉得这只是一场一开始吧，公开赛吧，所以说自己还是要放平自己的心态，因为赢一场球也不能证明自己什么嘛，我觉得还是要去
Dubbed as the next Lin Dan, left-hander Weng reveres his renowned senior but has every intention of charting his own path.
I think 因为而且他的荣耀辉煌我们都就是从小都是看他比赛长大的嘛，所以很多东西这东西学习的，但是我觉得其实也不要给自己太大压力嘛，去做好自己的每一步嘛，就是要有比赛或要有什么的去全力做好自己吧。其实我个性啊就挺确实有点腼腆嘛，就是在场上 有时候会不太会去善于表达自己，可能就是比较去更注重在场上嘛，可能在对于自己也没有说很张扬放嘛，很放开嘛，就是主要是还是注重于在场上的场上球吧，我觉得就是更注重于在战术上或心态上。
สบายดีไหมสบายดีไหมสบายดีไหมอันนี้เท่าไหร่อันนี้เท่าไหร่อันนี้เท่าไหร่อันนี้เท่าไหร่หิวข้าวไหมหิวข้าวไหมหิวข้าวไหมหิวข้าวไหมขอโทษค่ะขอโทษค่ะขอโทษค่ะขอโทษค่ะ
ไม่เป็นไรไม่เป็นไรไม่เข้าใจไม่เข้าใจไม่เข้าใจไม่เข้าใจ Coming up after a short break, Russian lock Internon takes up the emoji challenge and Kevin Cordon talks about inspiring others to aim for the skies with his Olympic semi-final performance.
It's not about sports, it's not about the Olympics, it's all about the small countries like Guatemala.
Guatemala's Kevin Cordon became an overnight sensation after a stunning campaign at Tokyo 2020 that almost saw the then world number 59 finish with a medal. Unfancied right from the start, the 35-year-old ran riot at the Musashino Forest Sport Plaza, only to be stopped by the fifth-seeded Anthony Sinisuka Ginting in the bronze medal match.
When you are an athlete, you have two dreams. First, to qualify for Olympics, and the second, to get a medal. And I'm happy, not because I lost the medal. I'm happy that I had two chances to get a medal, so I'm still thinking like that.
Tokyo was Cordon's fourth appearance at the Summer Games, but with the pandemic derailing sporting events in 2020, it could have easily been the one he missed out. But the Guatemalan ace was determined to earn his spot, especially after a disappointing outing at Rio 2016.
It was like 7 weeks, I think, before the Olympic qualification finished, and I wasn't qualified yet. So I was, okay, bad luck, all this COVID and all these things came. And then I realized, okay, it's not like I'm wasting my time. I have one more year to have 12 months to have a good, more preparation, more training. It was a tournament in Guatemala, Pan Am Championships. And then I got reached semifinals in with these points, I was 100% sure that I was qualified. And I was very, very happy because, you know, after Rio, after my injury in my knee, to qualify again, it was like, again, my dream come true. So I was really, very, very happy.
Tokyo 2020 saw Cordon drawn into Group C along with Lino Munoz and the eight-seeded Unka Long Angus.
When I saw that I was going to play the Mexican guy, my friend, he's my friend, I said, okay, I have a chance to win at least one match. And when I saw the guy from Hong Kong, so, okay. I knew that it was going to be like at least one tough match. At least I will play two matches. I was thinking about 2016, and I played only one match. And I said, okay, I have two matches, so I will do my best. I don't care about if I want to win, I just want to have fun. I just want to play.
The Central American went on to defy everybody's expectations. Cordon won all his group matches convincingly, edged past Dutchman Mark Kallio before upsetting an unsung Hyo Kwang Hee in the knockout rounds.
Since the first point, the last point, I was just thinking like this. I was not thinking, okay, I won this guy and I won the number 8 in the world. No. I was just playing. I was not thinking about, okay, I'm in Olympic Games and I am the last 16 or quarterfinals. No. I was just playing. And then when I had the chance to be in the quarterfinals, play the guy from Korea, I said, okay, it doesn't matter. It's Korea, Japan. I was telling my coach, I will do the same. I will play, I will have fun, I will play point by point, and we'll see what happens. Okay, 2 sets, and it was just really nice. When I beat this the Korean guy, I just started to cry because I realized, okay, I am in semifinals.
Plotting the downfall of eventual champion Victor Axelsen next would have needed something extra special, and as much as he tried against the much younger Ginting, his Indonesian opponent proved in straight games he was worthy of the Olympic bronze. For Cordon, by thrusting his nation into the limelight on the biggest sporting stage, he'd achieved more than he could have imagined.
It's not about sports. It's not about the Olympics. It's all about the small countries like Guatemala can have like a really big dreams. Now the people think that if they dream and they can work really, really hard, they had a chance to get anything they want. Right now I'm step by step. So I will play 1 year and then my body, it's okay, I will continue. So 3 more years, so I hope I can qualify again for Olympics and having fun.
Peru has many players, many things to give to the country. I want to be one of them, to get a medal for my country, for my family, and for God.
Carmen Giuliana Poveda Flores has done that and more. Still just 20 years of age, Flores is the reigning SH6 Women's Singles World Champion and also dominates the doubles category on the international para badminton circuit. The world number one sat down with Badminton Unlimited and revealed her fierce desire to play at her first Paralympics come 2024.
It was in Colombia. My first tournament was a Pan Am Championship. It was so excited because I play against men. I was the first woman playing America, and it was so nice because I got bronze medal in singles and then gold medal in mixed doubles. Yes, I don't have idea in the time to win because Rachel is a good player. She has 10 years in badminton. She has a lot of experience. I was new. I was really nervous in that time. I only trust in God and in my family because they was there. Their love helped me a lot to win this day. I think about my dad. My dad died when I was 11 years old, and everything I have is for him. So I give to him my victory, and it was too good, and I am so proud to be his daughter. Yes, it's for him I won. Obviously, I was a little sad to not be there, because I think when I won the world champions, I think about the Paralympics. I say I want to gold medal, and also for Peru. For many years ago, hasn't had a medal, and I think maybe if I was in Tokyo, maybe won a medal there. It was nice to SF6 are in Paris. Now it's like equality, like men's, and now women's are in power, and it's to me too nice. And I hope many girls coming to play badminton in my category, and it's better when there are more girls in SF6. When I got the news, I say to my family, because they are so important to me, and they need to know that Giuliana Poveda will be in Paris. Trying to go into many tournaments and also to get the first place in that tournament. I wanted to participate in Pan Am Games and get a medal there, the gold medal, if it is possible. And then to continue to prepare to Paris. I need to focus now in Paris. It will be more difficult. Many girls, Asian girls are coming, and they are so well. I am trying to put more hours in my trainings and less in the studying, but maybe 60 or 70% in sports and study 30. And I will try to do my best, and maybe doing a camp in other countries to improve my technique.
That's all we have for you. Next week, Li Yang and Wang Qilin square off in a friendly challenge. and the first Olympic gold medalist from Chinese Taipei describe life after Tokyo.
I feel pretty unreal, but now I'm getting used to it. Maybe other people will expect you.
Before we go, do mark July 5th on your calendar for the first World Badminton Day, when many fun and inclusive badminton events will take place globally. Go to corporate.bwfbadminton.com for more details. Bye and have a great sporting week ahead.